Hey, it's SGU, and we are back with the Joe Broadway Road to the Show series here in MLB The Show 19. Joe coming in with an impressive hitting streak here. We've gone over 20 games, and we hope to continue that as we try to make a surge also for first place. There you see 21-game hitting streak officially coming into play today. It's going to be interleague baseball against the Miami Marlins, and we'll see if that streak will indeed continue.
The show is on the air with Saturday Night Baseball from Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Tonight, the start of a three-game interleague series between the Miami Marlins and the New York Yankees. Interleague baseball comes your way next.
Okay, so here we go, stepping into the batter's box for the first time. Got a little bit of rain here at Yankee Stadium as we start this homestand with interleague play against the Marlins, and a runner on first base, and this is destroyed down the left field line. Is it fair? Looks like it stays fair. Didn't take long for us to get a Broadway bomb in this one. Challenge completed as well, as he takes this one into the seats and left, going, 439 feet down the line, a two-run shot, and he may have put this in the second deck. We'll have to take a look at the replay. All I know is the Yankees strike first, and it is their slugger doing the damage as he pulls this one. Like I said, just had to keep it fair. He was hoping, and he did exactly that into that second deck. Sweet swing right here. The power swing of Joe Broadway hitting that Broadway bomb. So one for one. Artie's come through big. What's his second at bat going to bring us? Well, we're up 2-1 in the third inning. Nobody on and two outs, and he hits it hard, but it's going right at the right fielder there. Opposite field, line drive out, and he's one for two. Let's take it out to the field. Top of the sixth inning, still 2-1 score. As teams are struggling to get runs in the rain. And there's a nice play coming in and fielding the bunt and throwing it over to first to get that out. So we've extended the lead to 3-1, bottom of the sixth. And this ball to right field. Come on, carry. Carry on out. Yeah, no. That one's not even to the warning track, and it's going to be caught by the center fielder. So he's going to get one more shot here in this game. And we'll see where the score's at. Hopefully we wanted to play extras to get our victory. You got two on and nobody out. Big spot right here for Broadway. He's going to hit it to right field again. And right about the same spot. Right fielder plays it this time. Runner's going to tag from second to third and be safe. And it turns out we make this, a 6-1 ball game. So the Yankees take the first game here of interleague play against the Marlins. And they get to celebrate in the rain. Nice job. Just one hit for Broadway. But it was a big one. A two-run homer, giving them all the offense they actually needed in that game. How about game two of this series? Let's go right back on out to Yankee Stadium.
A welcome in to folks around the country. Sunday Night Baseball now from Yankee Stadium. Tonight, game two of this three-game interleague series between the Miami Marlins and the New York Yankees. Yankees baseball comes your way next.
All right, leave it to me to bring out another weird uniform combo. We got the standard jersey tops there, although I think they might be the 1970s variety. You got the dark navy pants. I think we mix and matched a cap for this. You know, that's the fun of being able to mix and match the uniforms as you get to play around with a little bit. When you got a team with such a traditional look like the Yankees, you got to have a little fun once in a while and spread it around a little and change it up. So there's a ground ball that is going to be fielded no problem by Broadway. It ends the inning. So he's hitting an even 400 coming into this at bat. 0-for-1 on the day. Trying to extend that hitting streak to 22 games. Or would it be 23? Actually, he's going for 23 today. That's off the fence. He's got a double. Runner thinking about coming home. He will score on the play. It's an RBI double, and we have extended the hitting streak now. I don't think they're going to acknowledge it with the graphic here, but it is 23 games and counting. It's actually kind of funny because a couple of these games he played, I think the one where he hit the home run in the first inning,
fast.
And then this one also, the commentary leading the game said, oh, he's running out of time. It looks like the streak is going to die, when he had already accomplished it. I just thought that was kind of funny that those triggered, despite the fact he had already gotten hits. And there's another hit for good measure, a single. But the Yankees got to get it in gear here. They're down 2-1 in the bottom of the sixth. Nobody out. Now, I don't think they got anything home that time because they got nothing to show you on the base pass. 2-for-3 is Joe, though, as he steps in again. And you know, just one Broadway bomb away from tying this thing. It's hit hard, but that's going to be right at the center fielder, a line drive out. Dynamic challenge fails. He fails to get them back into a tie, and it looks like they're running out of time in this one. The Marlins will finish it off and win 2-1, evening up this series. So the Yankees were hoping for a victory. That is not the case today, as they will fall 2-1 to the visiting Marlins. We're actually not going to be checking out the third game of the series. Just know that Joe does get one hit to extend the hitting streak further.
A dominating hitter gets a call from his representative.
All right, so the agent, John Kent, checking in here now. Interesting story. I know it was kind of the foreseen, foretold story that he would end up here as a Yankee and end up here long term. But, you know, we kind of started thinking about that. That's a long contract to play out.
The player expresses interest in going elsewhere.
So we did put in for a trade. We told him to shop around for a trade because, you know, I don't know that anybody wants to watch six more seasons of the Yankees. Just for variety's sake, we're thinking if they pull a trade, whatever. We would go with that just for the variety of teams and all that in this series. So 24-game hitting streak coming into today.
From 161st Street here in the Bronx, MLB The Show's got baseball from Yankee Stadium. Tonight, it's an AL Eastern Division matchup between the Baltimore Orioles and the New York Yankees. Joe Broadway aims to bring his hitting streak to 25 straight games right after this.
Homestand at Yankee Stadium continues. New series begins against the Baltimore Orioles. Broadway at 29 home runs, 29 Broadway bombs. Be nice to hit it even 30 at this point of the season. Obviously, it is early still, and he has set all sorts of records along his way the past couple seasons. And, he's only competing with himself when it comes to home runs in a season now these days, toppling his own record. If he can continue to do so. It's 1-0 right now, and a very interesting choice. Runners at the corners and two outs, and you decide to bunt for a hit, but it doesn't work out. Broadway sniffs that out, throws him out at first base. Still think that needs to be addressed in the AI. It's quite a bug, those two-out bunts, especially with runners on, and just do not make a whole lot of sense. Anyway, stepping up to the plate here in the fourth inning, 1-0 Yankees. It's ripped to left, deep, and it's not gone, but it's off the fence. Going to carry him back towards the infield and put the brakes on quickly there to be at second base, but that's a double.
And the screen shows the story right there, as that hitting streak will live to see another day.
He certainly has. He's seeing the ball so big, Matty. You see the confidence oozing off him in the box. He hasn't fished at anything in the last month or so.
25-game hitting streak. It's become quite a big one now to follow, to the point where we really don't want to sim games forward until that comes to an end, because we don't want to ruin things. And we know at some point they'll probably put us in a pinch hitting situation that'll test that streak as well. But there is an RBI single making it 4-0. And now you got a ball to left that's going to drop. And he's going first to third because nobody's covering third. Throw goes home. That's not going to get anybody out. Some sloppy play by the Orioles. And it's now 5-0 Yankees. We'll take it. Broadway's going to get another at bat. Already 2-for-3. And he'll get another chance here. Dynamic challenge. We're going to go hit a double or better. Yep, go big or go home. 6-0 at this point in the seventh inning, and it is a base hit past the second baseman. It's rolling kind of in the gap right there. He never hesitates, and he gets to second base with the hustle double. He wanted to complete that dynamic challenge, and that's exactly what he did, getting two bags. Let's watch the hustle effort right here from Broadway. He could have been fine with a single, but he knew what his challenge was, and he's legging this out. There you go. It's usually the kind of play you see out of a Skeeter Rabbit, not out of Joe Broadway, but hey, if you know what you're doing out there, you don't need to be super fast. You just need to be aggressive. This is going to be an easy run scoring here as Broadway comes home from second base on that ball down the right field line, and the Yankees are in control 7-0. Broadway even gets another at-bat coming up here. He could make it four hits in this game. He's got two runners on, and he's going to put the ball in the air. Left center field. Oh, my. Are we going to hit it out of here? Nope. It's going to be caught ahead of the warning track, so he gave it a ride, but just not enough juice to muscle it on out of the park. So the Yankees get a big win here, though. 7-1 is the final. And Broadway's got that hit streak going now at 25 games. So that's where we'll close it out for today's episode with a double, a single, and another double. And we'll pick right back up in this Baltimore series when we come back because we do not want to give up on the hitting streak. And look at the Yankees, just a half game back of the Red Sox, holding their own, holding their spot there in second place in the AL East. We'll see you guys next time for more Joe Broadway.